When you gaze up at the night sky, you probably recognize the iconic Big Dipper. But did you know that it's not actually a constellation? It's what's called an asterism. Let's define the two terms. A constellation is an official group of stars that includes a defined area of the night sky recognized by the International Astronomical Union. It's kind of like how states and countries have borders on maps. Well, in the night sky, we use constellations to mark borders to define all the space up in space. An asterism is what you probably thought a constellation was. It's just a recognized pattern of stars with a common name, and it can include stars from multiple constellations or just a few stars from one constellation. The Big Dipper is one such asterism, and it is part of a greater constellation called Ursa Major, which is Latin for the Great Bear. Here's everything you need to know about the constellation Ursa Major. History and mythology. In Greek mythology, the constellation Ursa Major symbolizes Callisto, the stunning nymph who enchanted Zeus. To hide her from his wife Hera, Zeus transformed Callisto into a bear. Weird choice, I know, but whatever. Years later, Callisto's son Arcas nearly hunted her unknowingly. To avert tragedy and stop Callisto from being hunted, Zeus placed both Callisto and Arcas up in the sky as constellations. So the story goes. Callisto being the great bear, Ursa Major, and Arcas being Bootes, the watcher of the bear, or something like that. In Christianity, some associate Ursa Major with a pasture or sheepfold, which in the original Hebrew may sound similar to the Hebrew word for bear. This is, however, a creative interpretation, not really grounded in history, but I'm a little biased, so I threw it in because I thought it was interesting. Many North American indigenous cultures see the Big Dipper as a bear being pursued by hunters. The cup represents the bear, and the handle, three hunters. This myth is often used to explain seasonal changes where the wounded bear colors the autumn leaves red. When to see this constellation? Ursa Major is a circumpolar constellation and can only be seen from the northern horizon. Because of its unique position, it can be seen all year long as it spins around the North Pole. Throughout history, it has played a crucial role in navigation. The Big Dipper's location near the North Star makes it a useful tool for determining direction. Ursa Major is home to several bright, notable stars that make it easily recognizable. Again, the most prominent feature of this constellation is the Big Dipper, sometimes known as the plow or the wagon. You can find this constellation by looking north pretty much any time of the year. However, in the early evening hours of the autumn, it falls lower in the horizon, while in the spring it rises higher in the horizon and kind of rotates upside down. In the winter, it pushes slightly east, and in the summer it is more west. That is, of course, if you're stargazing just after sunset, it will rotate counterclockwise around the North Pole as the night progresses. Keep in mind that it is a fairly big constellation, in fact, the third largest constellation total, and the first largest constellation in the northern hemisphere, so it will take up a big area of space in the sky. And it should be able to be seen even with some light pollution because those stars are pretty bright. Next, let's cover the three most interesting stars and the three most interesting deep sky objects that you can look for in your telescope. Alioth is the brightest star in this constellation, and it is Arabic for the sheep's fat tail. Its magnitude is about plus 1.75, so that's fairly bright. Alioth, along with four other stars in the Big Dipper, belongs to the Ursa Major moving group, which is the closest stellar moving group to Earth. That means it's a group of stars moving in the same direction at roughly the same speed, and is thought to be the remnants of an open star cluster. This next one is one to pull out the binoculars for. Mizar is, in fact, an optical double star. If you look closely at this star in the handle of the Big Dipper, near the middle of the handle, you will see two stars up there. Often mistaken for one, but if you look closely, you can see both of them. The second star is named Alcor, but if you look at Mizar through a powerful telescope, you'll see that it's actually a quadruple star system. And finally, a two-for-one combo. We have the two stars at the end of the Dipper, Mirak and Dubhay. Not sure exactly on the pronunciation there. These are known as the pointer stars because they can be used to find the North Pole. So if you start at Mirak and go through Dubhay for about five times the distance between them, Then you'll land on Polaris, the northern star. There are actually mini galaxies that can be found in Ursa Major, and some of them should be visible through a backyard telescope. Here are a few of the brightest objects in the Great Bear. First, M101. This has an apparent magnitude of about 7.8. So if you keep in mind, 6.5 is about the limit of what you can see with the naked eye. Just beyond that, just a little bit. This is what's called a spiral galaxy, and it is also known as the Pinwheel galaxy. So this is one of the brightest deep sky objects in this constellation. The next options we have are M81 and M82. These are two prominent galaxies in the constellation Ursa Major. M81 has a magnitude of about 6.9, and it is also known as Bode's galaxy. It's a large spiral galaxy as well. And M82, with a magnitude of about 8.4, it is nicknamed the Cigar Galaxy. It's an irregular starburst galaxy. That's what they call it. These galaxies are notable for their close proximity to each other and their visibility through amateur telescopes. Next we have M97, which has a magnitude of about 9.8. This is also known as the Owl Nebula, and this one's a bit dimmer. You might need some photography equipment to really get the most out of it, but it's worth checking out through your telescope to see if you can see a bit of a faint smudge or something like that. So next time you look up at the night sky and you see the Big Dipper, you'll think, wow, that's a pretty cool asterism. Not a constellation. And you should check out Alcor and Mizar, the optical double star. Maybe look at your binoculars through it and see if you can find the Pinwheel Galaxy. Hey, let me know what you learned today down in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. Look up and remember to smile.